moving right along, you can similarly define the matrix 1 norm. And you might say, well, that's just as hard to evaluate as the matrix 2 norm. I don't see the difference. Okay, well, let's take a arbitrary matrix. Let's make this 1 minus 1. We want to evaluate the matrix 1 norm. It turns out there's a very simple formula for this. You compute the vector 1 norm of the first column. What is that? Absolute value of 2 plus absolute value of 1 is 3. You compute the vector 1 norm of the second column. What is that? 3 plus 1 is 4. And then you look at the maximum of those two, and the maximum of those two is the 1 norm of the matrix. Now, we need to prove that. You can't just take my word for it. So you're going to go through some exercises that help you discover that indeed there is a general formula like this. But the important thing is the matrix 1 norm is simple to evaluate, and the matrix 1 norm has this relation to linear transformations where it measures how much the linear transformation stretches using the 1 norm for the input and for the output. Now let's look at the matrix infinity norm. Defining it is easy. We just replace everything with the infinity norm. And now let's move over here and ask the question, what is the infinity norm of this matrix? Well, turns out again, there is a simple formula for this. You look at the vector 1 norm of the row. So you think of this as a column vector. You take its 1 norm. The 1 norm here is 5. And for the second row is 2. And then you take the maximum of those two numbers, and it turns out to be 5. So again, we see that there appears to be a simple formula, if you trust me, or more importantly, if you go through the exercises. And therefore, the infinity norm is simple to evaluate. It again has this relation to linear transformations and measuring the magnitude of a linear transformation. Like the 1 norm, the infinity norm is not differentiable.